Hey, what is up, guys? My name is Cosmin and I have a new video today. Even though I have a cold, I'm still going to record something. I was planning on doing a small illustration. The previous screen was the inspiration I gathered from Dribbble, and that got me in the mood of trying something similar, a very minimal illustration with maybe two colors and some use of negative space. So this is the sketch I did. Now I did it real quick, trying to figure out the whole idea. I wanted to have someone with a summer hat on and somehow blend in with the background shape. So this was the second variation of that initial sketch. And even though I like it, it feels kind of flat. So I tried to tighten it up and give it more personality, even though the main goal was to have the hat be the main point of focus. I wanted to have a sun and maybe the sea behind, but I wasn't sure about it, so I started doing multiple variations and in the end ended up with this one. Now let's move over to Illustrator, where I just placed this image. Now I'll lower its opacity and lock this layer up so I can trace over it and not have to worry about accidentally moving it. So let's just zoom in and I can start tracing the image using the pen tool. Even though my curves are looking good, I just use the smooth tool, you can find it there, and I just go over every single line and it will smooth it out. As you can see right here, that curve is not perfect. So what I do, I just click and drag on top of it and it's going to smooth it out. It's going to add more anchors and it's going to make it look more natural. I slowed down the video here just to show you how I used the round circle to create the face outline. I will be adding a couple of anchors and adjust it a bit to give it more personality, but this is the face for now. Whenever I want to have consistent round corners summer, I just draw straight lines, straight 90 degrees angles, and then I just direct click on the anchor and drag using that small circle. At this point, I don't really like the illustration and how it looks, just because everything looks so even and symmetrical. So I start adding pads with different colors, for this example with white, just to give it an asymmetrical look, just to give it more personality. it's good from time to time to just zoom out and see what gets your attention and focus on that. For example, for this one, the shoulders seem kind of uneven. I have way too much negative space on the right hand side, so I just wanted to add a couple of more volume for the hair to cover it up. I would also like to mention that from time to time it's great to just reflect the whole illustration and see it from another perspective and see what stands out. For example, when I did this, I saw that those top elements were way too big for the whole illustration, so I just started drawing over them and adjusting those lines. Since we're at the end of the process, I just selected the two color schemes I like the most, and once I place it on top of the sketch, I'll just remove the initial sketch from the background just so I can focus on color. And I wanted to experiment a bit with something more contrasting that will replace this light blue. Just because with this light blue, the negative space doesn't really stand out. So I just tried maybe getting something lighter, or maybe getting something like a red. And in the end, I feel like using red is looking so much better. Now I selected inside Photoshop an airbrush with that has grains, just to try and see if I can give it more volume, just using white. And of course I have a Wacom tablet, but you can do this with the mouse as well, and just add a couple of speckles to give it more volume. This is the final illustration. You can download it for free inside the description, and let me know if you have any questions. As always, I'll be more than happy to help. Till next time, bye.